Let's use the TI-84 to calculate the correlation coefficient and also to find the equation of the linear regression line. Before we do this, we need to activate a feature on our calculator, and we're going to do that by going to the catalog. And if I look above the zero key, I'll see in teeny tiny little print the word catalog. So to access it, I'll press the second key and then the zero key, and that's my catalog. And this is just an index of all of the functions on your calculator. So I'll scroll down, 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 or I know that I'm heading to the entries that begin with the letter D, so maybe I'll just press the key that corresponds to the letter D, and that'll take me to the first entry that starts with the letter D. And then I'll scroll down from here, and I'm looking for an entry that says diagnostics on. And there it is, diagnostic on. So I press the enter key and then enter again, and it tells me done. So this has activated the diagnostics on the calculator. Once I've done this now, I don't have to do this again until someone resets the memory on my calculator or you know, that sort of thing. Okay, so let's suppose that I have entered data into a couple of lists. So my y values are in list 1, my x values are in list 2. To calculate the correlation coefficient, I press the stat key, then I toggle to the right to calc, and I choose choice number 4, which is linear regression. And when I do that, I have to tell it which list to look at. So my data is in list number 1, so the second one, comma, list 2. When I press enter, I see the equation of the regression line as well as the correlation coefficient. So the last entry here, the R value, is the correlation coefficient. Now, if I had not taken the time to turn on the diagnostics, then I would not see these last two lines of data. So if your screen happens to only have information for the line and not the R values here, then that's what's happened. Your diagnostics are off. All right, so the correlation coefficient here is 0.8. The equation of the regression line is above that, and it's in the form y equals ax plus b. And then a would be replaced with the value of 0.8, b would be replaced with a value of 4.5. So the regression line would be y equals 0.8x plus 4.5. Now, if on this set of data, I had also drawn a scatter plot, and I had gone through the motions to do that, I might be looking like this. If I want to see the line get drawn across that data, what I do is press my y equal key, and my cursor is waiting for me to enter the equation. Now, I can type it in if I've written it on my paper, right? I could type it in by hand, but a slicker way to get the equation here is to press your VARS key and then choose number 5, which is statistics, and then toggle to the right to equation, and then choice number 1 is regression equation. And what your calculator will do is it'll pick up the very last regression equation it generated and pop it into this level at Y1. Now when I hit my graph key, I'll see the scatter plot, but I'll also see the line come across the screen.